student, I'm Rose. Today we are going to learn a new chapter, that is Standard 7, History, Chapter 6, Town Traders and Craftsmen. So we are going to learn a very interesting topic, Town Traders and Craftsmen. So during the medieval period, there was various development happened in various ways, like you can say in a political way, in an economic way, or in a financial way. Yes or no? So we can say it developed in agriculture, it developed in industry, it developed in trades and commercial, and even we can say what we call the development, or we can say there were different political development in the India, in India. Okay, so we can say large number of towns, and we can say towns were being developed during the medieval period. So in the early medieval period, as we know about who are the rulers who rule over India, like you can say Rashtraputas, Vijaya Pratiharas, they were ruling over the North India, and even in the Southern India, if you talk about, they were the Cholas. Yes or no? So these are the important rulers who ruled over the early medieval period. After that, you can say after these all rulers, there came a sultanate, that means foreign ruler came to India, that were the sultans of Delhi, who were ruling over from the Delhi. Yes or no? Then you can say after the Delhi sultanate, there were the Mughal Empire. Yes or no? So these are the important rulers who ruled over India. Yes or no? And they were having their own way of ruling for the development purpose or in a administrative way. Yes or no? So during that time, there were various development happened. There was various development happened within their own administrative center, the towns, and even we can say that what we call trade and commercial flourished during the reign of Delhi Sultanate and the Mughal Empire. Like we say, trade connection between the European countries or the Arab countries. Okay, these are the trade connection which was built during the reign of these all rulers. Okay, so what happened? There were various traders who traveled from one place to another. They also observed which are the towns or which are the cities which are developing in different ways, and according to that, they used to travel from one place to another and they used to sold the goods. Okay, so this is what are the things which was happening. Okay, so in the last chapter, we have learned about the architecture of medieval period, architecture in medieval period. So there were different kings and rulers who were ruling over the country. Yes, and they brought their own styles or design from various places. For example, Sultanate and the Mughal Empire, they were the foreign ruler. So they brought their own way of architecture, like they say, Indo-Islamic style. And if you talk about the southern region, that means southern India, there were the Cholas. So Pallavas, okay, these are the rulers who were present in the southern region, and they also were having their own way of architecture, we can say Dravidian style. And in the northern, like it's a Rajput rulers, there were different Rajput rulers, they were having the what we call Dravidian styles of the what we call architecture. Okay, so in the northern, you can say in the northern region, they were having the Nagara style of architecture in the northern region. Okay, so these are the different architecture of building of different temples. Okay, so in the southern region, mainly it was famous for the temples, and in the northern, some part of the northern, it was also famous for the northern. So they were having different styles of architecture. So, and due to that, what happened, there were different towns which was developed during the medieval period. Okay, so you can see which are the different types of towns which are being developed, like it's a fort town, temple town, and the commercial town. Okay, so in the commercial town, there are two towns, that is the fort town and the trading towns. Okay, so in the fort town, if you talk about, it is also called the capital town. Okay, so here, for example, if you talk about the Delhi Sultanate, during the Delhi Sultanate, they used to rule from Delhi. Yes or no? They used to rule from Delhi. They used to administrate, we can say, from their only, uh, look after different departmental things of the different regions of the kingdom. Yes or no? So we can say that this Delhi become one of the town and the developed town, and it flourishes in administrative way. And if you talk about here in the southern region, one of the best example is the Thanjavur. Thanjavur is also famous for the capital or the capital town. Okay, so this was one of the best town, or we can say which was developed in the Chola dynasty, and we can say it was also famous for the temple town. It is also famous for the temple town, or and even the commercial town. Okay, so Thanjavur was famous for all three towns. Like we say, temple towns, even for the commercial town. So this was developed in three ways. We can say in an administrative way also it developed, and even in the temple where they built different types of temples in this capital. Okay, then we have in the commercial way also it developed in this region. Okay, so this is how the temples was developed. Okay, towns was developed. For example, how we can say that how the temples are being developed. For example, in the administrative or we can say court or capital town, if you talk about, the king used to settle here. Okay, and he was having his own town, or we can say his own mahal or his own court. Yes or no? And from here, this Sultan's or we can say king used to bring around relatives from. Their armies used to live in that town. So this is how the when the armies came, they built their own houses. Yes or no? So king used to develop their own house for these soldiers. Even then this soldier needs different kinds of things. So for that there are different traders who used to travel from different regions, and they used to sell the goods. Okay. So this is how. So this is how the capital town was being built. Okay. So if you talk about the temple town. So temple was, we can say that it is was the symbol of power, wealth, and devotion of the king in the deity. Yes or no? That is why temple was so much important, and they used to build this temple with so much effort and so much give different styles to the temples. For example, we can say the Mathura in the Uttar Pradesh. Mathura is here just below the Okay, so Mathura is it is in Uttar Pradesh. Okay, it is Uttar Pradesh. Then you have the Somnath in Gujarat. Okay, then you have the Bridhareshwar temple. Okay, so these are the important important temples which is famous, and it developed in this area. So much people used to settle around this area. For example, if you talk about, if you are going for a offering, if you are going to offer a prayer in any temple, okay, you used to take garland, then you have the flowers, then incense you will take, candle you will take, yes or no? Then you have the matches you will take for burning the incense. Okay, so these are things from where you will get. Yes or no? For this purpose, the craft person or the people used to sell around the temples. Okay, so and after the time passes, they started to settle around the temples. Okay, so that is why the people who used to offer prayer, they did not face any problem to travel long distance to buy the incense or flowers or garland, whichever it is, whichever things it is needed for the offering. Offering prayer. Okay, so this is how it's happened. Okay, so like this temple town started to grow. Temple town started to grow, and that time the king used to have so much devotion towards the deity or the god. Okay, that is why they used to even give funds to the temple. And there were so much, even the rich merchant, even they used to give the funds to the temple so that the temple town should grow in different. different ways. Okay, so this is how. So best example of the temple town, if you talk about, is the the Madurai, then you have the Mathura in the Uttar Pradesh, then you have the Madurai in Tamil Nadu. Madurai was also famous for the temple town. Okay, so this is how it's developed. Okay, now we are going to talk about the commercial town. Okay, so this commercial town developed in a two ways. That means one in the land, other in the port towns. Okay, there were two types of towns in commercial town. That means we can say port town and the trading town. So if you talk about the commercial town is actually a where the goods are being sold and bought. Okay, the goods are being sold and bought. Okay, so here we can say exchange of things are being happen according to the rate, according to the money fixed. Yes or no? For example, if you have gone to a local market in the village area, you can see how they used to buy and sell the goods. Yes or no? So same as what happened. This, as we know, India is surrounded by the water, sea. Yes or no? It is surrounded by the sea. And due to that, what happened? There are various cities which was being developed near the sea. Yes or no? For example, Surat, Bombay, then you have the Madurai, Tripura, Masulipatnam. Okay. So these are the important port towns which developed during the medieval period. Okay. For example, if you talk about the Surat, Surat is having a port and it is very famous during the medieval period, and it is famous for the diamond and the dyes used for the clothes, and even the cotton, even the textiles. So the foreign travelers or the foreign traders used to come to Surat, and they used to trade with Surat. Okay, so what happened here? We can say that like this, they used foreign countries used to come in the port town, and they used to have the exchange of goods. Okay, so this is how cities near or the towns near the sea area developed. For example, Bombay is also one type of a port town. It is famous for. Then we have the Masulipatnam. Masulipatnam is also famous for several dyes. We can say used and the textiles. Textile industry is being present in the Masulipatnam. Okay, so this is how the trading. So the traders used to observe which country is more benefit. Yes, and according to that, they used to travel from one place to another. Okay, so if you talk about the port towns where the Surat was one of the port towns, then you have the Bombay, then you have the Masulipatnam, Tripura, Kanchipuram was also one type of a commercial town. Okay, so this is how it's developed. Okay, now if you talk about the trading towns, like you can say, for example, if you talk about in any city, you have gone to Sabji Mandi or something like that. Yes or no? So where you used to exchange the goods or buy things. Yes or no? So in the land. So most famous trading for towns was, we can say that here you can see Ahmedabad was one of the trading towns. Then you have the Hampi. Hampi is also one type of administrative and the trading towns. Then you have the Tripoli, then you have the Kanchipuram. Okay, so these are the important trading towns which developed during the medieval period. Okay, so go through the chapter, and I hope that you will read your book properly, and when you will have the doctor in class, you can ask me. Thank you for now.